Okay, I gotta explain something to you, Chronic. Chronic, man, a lot of people, this is like Patriotard mythology. Many of the others, like Russia didn't actually fall, or like Kennedy got killed because of the Federal Reserve and not because of Israel's secret Jewish, you know, nuclear program. No, basically, what happened with Anne Frank is like, no, she wrote like most of the book, but her father, because she was like a little teenage girl, so she was writing nasty shit about her pussy and like, how she was rubbing it and like you know, like dirty panties, and like no father wants like that to come out, so like he it's fucking admitted to, like, took out pages of like from the fucking book, and then like he also added some other shit. That's where the ballpoint pen come from. Like the pen was his the father's additions to the book. You gotta listen to fucking not fucking the great hero Michael Collins Piper to get that kind of information. Real research. Not fucking Alex Jones, man. Reading off of web pages and during a radio show. What a son of a bitch.
Yeah. Man. Yesterday, the Dutch woman who helped Anne Frank died yesterday, so...
Good.
The real truth to get out is died.
She was never gonna say any truth, man. Don't.
Of course not.
She was breaking the law by helping Jewish people during the Nazi reign. So I don't fucking trust her. But Chronic, man, I gotta thank you. We have like a pretty. We got like enough material to like you know, spread our anti-Semitism. I mean, you know, not anti-Semitism, like because that'd be anti-Palestinian. No, I mean anti-Jew.
Yeah, that's why. That's because they make contradictions to everything. And everything that is left is actually right, just like Big Brother and the thought about that.
Yeah.
All by that.
Chronic, man, do you have any final words to give the audience?
Oh, sure. I got something to say.
Go for it.
Bananas is already dead since 2001. That's why I'm wearing this mask. And, what can I say more? He's not alive. And all these fake videos they still send. I wonder what the 2010 video of Bin Laden is going to be. How much CGI they're using. Was it?
Yeah. It's some bullshit, dude, man. It is, man.
I can't believe that people still think that he's alive, and then when they watch those videos, it's so fake.
It is, dude.
All the people are so stupid. They had so much fluoride. Drinking and a lot of aspartame and all those fucked up stuff.
Man.
So.
Man, fuck them. So, okay, man. thank you, Chronic.
I gotta say, audience, if you haven't woken up, wake the fuck up.
.info or also WTFU.net. Okay. Well, here's my fucking final statement. I got a little message for you, Alex Jones, okay, man? We don't fucking forget all this. Wait up, Chronic, man. We don't forget about like all this nasty shit you've been doing, man. Okay, look, let me give you a little fucking threat. Okay, you pretend you're from Texas, man. We know you're actually from Dallas. That's like Texas Yankees. Okay, between me and you, I'm from Houston, so you know I'm fucking. You're a piece of shit. You know I know telling the truth. You ain't fucking Texan. So like I challenge you, man. Don't ever fucking come to Europe. Because, like, let's just say, you know, I know people, and I know people who know people. There's a certain guy called, like, what's his name? Like, Noel or something from Belgium. He, like, puts fucking, you know, pies into motherfuckers' faces. That's gonna fucking happen to you. And if you ever come to, like, fucking, where is it? I'm gonna call that motherfucker and be like, hey, man, fucking son of a bitch came over, man. We gotta, like, go get his fucking ass. Get that fucking pie ready. Man, bring two fucking pies, because he'll eat the first one. I know, Chronic, can you imagine that? Like, you throw a pie at Alex Jones, he's like... Because so we have to have the spare pie. Like, oh, got another one. Chronic, I want to thank you for coming on the show.
Yeah, pleasure.
Thank you, Chronic.
Great to be alive on the show.
Thanks for helping me do a televised episode.
Ciao, ciao. For now.
Okay, now I decided to finally, you know, be like, do my creativeness. So, like, I want you to check out this little short clip. Oh, not really, because I consider it a movie. It's only like 2 minutes, but, you know, it's like, it's called The Conspiracy Theorist, and I just had this feelings, you know, I want to be artistic and shit. So, like, I know you're going to like it, so let's check it out. I'm quite proud of this Umunu production. Girl, all I ever wanted, all I ever needed is here in my arms. Words. At this point, I've been a conspiracy theorist for most of my life, and currently feel like I have a firm grasp of what the conspiracy is really like. But lately I've been thinking about all the people I've known throughout the years, ever since I started studying conspiracy theories. Most of them are gone now. It's a rather lonely lifestyle, but I absolutely do not regret ever getting into it, in spite of all the sacrifices that I've made. If I had a chance to talk to somebody, you know, just starting out, here are some words of wisdom I'd probably say to him. A conspiracy theorist is only as good as his knowledge, and his knowledge comes from his research. Now you've got to go out there and study the best ones that you can find. You've got to read them books. Watch them movies, you know, listen to them radio shows, but never forget, anybody can call themselves a researcher. The key is to stay away from those shills and their lies. It don't matter whether or not they're crazy or government agents, they'll have you running around in circles all the same. You see, these days, conspiracy theories, big business. But it's been going on since the beginning of man, and it's going to continue straight ahead until the great conspiracy finally reveals itself. Can you dig it? So good, man. That gave you like me, like, you know, the shakes. Well, the reason I did, like I'm saying, man, it's like I want everybody to like go out there and like, you know, make their own shit. So it ain't that fucking hard, and you just like spill a little, you know, mix around some shit. I mean, you're so fucking lazy out there. You're not even making your own fucking radio shows. I don't know what the fuck your problem is. Ugh. Well, I've hoped that you've enjoyed today's episode of the Joe Blow Conspiracy Show, and Chota Hafiz. See you guys. Bye-bye.
Vakti barot nakhon.